Hello, my name is Azizi Tucker, and welcome to TEDx Taipei 2013, Living Together. I'm not such a good environmentalist. I don't always recycle when I'm at home. I never unplug my electronic devices like I should. I race cars through the Mexican desert for fun, and I used to build spaceships which punch holes in the ozone layer with every launch. I have a few redeeming environmental qualities. I don't own a car, but that makes me just like most people here in Taipei City. Sometimes, when I go to Mos Burger, I can figure out where the paper or plastic waste goes. My carbon footprint is approximately 3 times the average American at 80 tons of CO2 per year, much higher than the average Taiwanese also. In short, I'm not an environmentalist. I'm actually very far from it. However, I do care about the environment and want things to be better. I think in many ways, I'm like many of you here, where I want things to be better, but my actions don't necessarily live up to my words. Why am I here? I was born in Oakland, California, and grew up as the mountain bike was just being developed in the San Francisco Bay Area. I began mountain biking when I was just 8 years old, and before the term was even commonplace. In my teens, I began to race mountain bikes downhill and did very well at the high-speed races. While growing up and riding bicycles, I've always had a love of cars and dreamed of racing cars in the future. My love of cars led me away from the San Francisco Bay Area once I finished high school into Detroit, Michigan, the Motor City. I studied engineering at University of Michigan and hoped to work in the car industry. I was lucky enough to get a job at a large automotive supplier in the automotive industry. My company manufactured complete engines and engine parts for Ford, GM, and Chrysler. At the time, we produced over 1,000 gas-guzzling V8 engines every day. These engines were made for the very large SUVs that were popular in the 1990s and early 2000s. While working in Detroit, I began to race cars. I was finally fulfilling one of my dreams. I raced almost every weekend, and me and my friends would drive all over the U.S. to attend races. While working in the automotive industry, I worked on and saw many innovative projects that made it through testing, a little bit of development, but were canceled before production started. There were several high-efficiency diesel engines that were perfect for the large SUVs of the time that were canceled due to lack of customer demand. The project that intrigued me the most was the Chrysler Patriot. It was a natural gas electric hybrid race car, which was designed and partially tested before it was canceled in the 1990s. At the time, I was very surprised and very interested. I had no idea that something powered by electricity, an electric car, could reach speeds of 300 kilometers per hour. The project was eventually canceled by Chrysler management in 1996. 1 year later, 1997, Toyota unveiled the first production hybrid car, the Toyota Prius. I saw the approach of the decline of the American automotive industry and became frustrated with the lack of innovation. I moved from the automotive industry to the aerospace industry to get a chance to work with the very best and learn from the very best. Working at NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center, I was exposed to some of the very best cutting-edge technology. However, the pace of development was just far too slow for my taste. I was bored. I moved back to the San Francisco Bay Area after 3 years at NASA Goddard, and my love of cars led me to become one of the early employees at Tesla Motors. When I moved back to the San Francisco Bay Area, there were only two choices to work in the automotive industry. I could work for Tesla Motors, a small startup with fewer than 100 employees, or I could go work for NUMMI. It was a huge GM and Toyota joint venture with more than 6,000 employees. The cars from Tesla Motors were fast. The cars for GM and Toyota were slow and boring. My decision was made. My parents were a bit worried, but the job at Tesla turned out to be a wonderful accident. The work that I'd loved all my life had finally begun to help instead of hurt the environment. A flip had happened for myself. I was able to do more racing and also some long distance racing in the desert. Early in my racing career, I began to produce my own parts. This allowed me to keep up with the more wealthy competitors Through racing, I honed my engineering skills with real-life successes and many, many failures. TED stands for Technology, Entertainment, and Design. Technologists build the building blocks for the things in our world. Entertainers bring ideas and products to the masses. Designers make the products that we love, and not always because of how they function. My answer here is, don't be an environmentalist because it's good for the planet. Be an environmentalist because it can make you rich. Be an environmentalist because it's more fun. Be an environmentalist because it's convenient. Be an environmentalist because it simply looks good. And finally, be an environmentalist just because it's what everyone else is doing. Accidental environmentalism, money. You can make money from selling green products. When I started at Tesla Motors in 2006, there were less than 100 employees. There had not been a successful US car company in the previous 81 years. That company, by the way, was Chrysler, which has been bailed out by the US government twice and has once declared bankruptcy. There were 780 failed car companies in the United States. The odds were certainly against us and our team at Tesla. During the time I was with the company, we grew to over 3,000 employees. We designed and built and tested our first car, the Tesla Roadster, in just 3 years. And sold out production run of 2,500 cars. The cost of each car was more than $100,000. The Tesla Roadster was the fastest, longest range electric vehicle ever made. Top speed was 210 kilometers per hour with a range of 350 kilometers. We followed this up with the Model S sedan, which launched a little over a year ago. Was awarded several Car of the Year awards at its launch. The factory currently is running full production and has produced more than 15,000 cars. Company stock was initially $17 and is now trading at around $180 per share. Simply, you can make money building green products. In addition, that's what I did in the past. The question is, what will I do next? For me, the thing that excites me about products is products that are fun. As a longtime bike rider and racer, I considered building my own electric bike when I worked at Tesla Motors. Me and my colleagues would have casual lunchtime conversation about taking the Tesla technology and combining it with an electric bicycle to make a really nice high-speed electric bicycle. Like so many lunchtime conversations, that was just idle chatter and nothing came from it. 6 months after I left Tesla to start my engineering consulting company here in Taipei, my friends here in Taiwan encouraged me to build my own electric bicycle. My electric bicycles have a top speed of 70 kilometers per hour and a range of 100 kilometers on one battery. They are good for the environment and offer reduced pollution transportation. While these bicycles are friendly for the environment, that is not my focus at all. It is all about fun and fast fun. My initial goal was to build the kind of bicycle or motorcycle that I wanted powered by electricity. I quickly realized, however, that I had a product that would appeal to the gasoline motorcycle owners here in Taiwan and around the world. Several big bike motorcycle riders have test ridden my bike, and they all immediately love it and plan to buy them soon. Not once has any of them said, "Oh, I like this product, this is good for the environment, so I'll buy one." For them, like you and like me, we buy products based on the way they look, feel, or cost. My newest project is LMD Racing, and you can see some of our cars over here to the right of the stage. I met my partners in LMD Racing, Daniel and Zong Shin, about 2 years ago while I was shopping for a racing car to drive here in Taiwan. As we got to know each other, Daniel mentioned to me that he had a dream of building his own series of electric car or series of racing cars here in Taiwan. I had done several car designs, but had never developed or brought any of them to production. As we researched and interviewed drivers about what kind of race car would sell well in the Asian market, we refined the concept and we quickly settled on a gasoline V8 engine as the ideal engine for our race car. Big power, low cost, reliable. During my time at Tesla, me and my colleagues had pushed for the idea of building an electric race car, but there simply was not the time, budget, or manpower to devote to a project like that. With the design of the LMD race car well underway, I mentioned casually to our team that I designed the car for both gasoline and a battery electric power. For normal people, there would have been many questions. How much does it cost? Where can it race? How long can it go? How long does it take to recharge? All of these are valid questions and they do deserve answers. For true race car drivers like Daniel and Zong Shin, however, there was only one question. How fast will it go? My answer of 300 kilometers per hour was all that's needed. We immediately updated our plan and started with two prototypes, one gasoline, one electric. Racing is an expensive sport, with people spending typically 50% of the purchase cost of the car every year just on maintenance. By building and selling electric cars, we will appeal to the fun and convenience for our customers. More time racing, less time doing the maintenance and repairing. But I know you're wondering, what are the environmental benefits of having an electric race car? The immediate effect is small, no pollution, drastically less noise pollution in addition. However, race cars and their drivers have large number of fans worldwide. Race car fans' street car purchases are heavily influenced by the race cars and racing that they love. This means electric race cars will drive and lead the sales of electric cars. Win on Sunday, sell on Monday is an old saying that about winning a race on Sunday will lead to sales at the dealership on Monday. In addition, the demanding world of racing has produced many innovations which have led to major improvements in road cars. ABS brakes, traction control, disc brakes, and even the rear view mirror. Not everyone can develop their own green products, but you can still do many things through accidental environmentalism, which will help the environment. One of the other things we do, both for LMD Racing and for My Electric Bikes, is local sourcing. We practice very local sourcing. Local sourcing means buying all the products and from local sources and suppliers that you can. I understand you can't get everything locally, but you want to try your best to do so. While this is occasionally more expensive than sourcing parts from overseas, it's far more convenient. You can easily visit your supplier, you speak the same language, you're in the same time zones. However, local sourcing also brings the benefit of a reduced CO2 production in your supply chain. Here's an example of our supply chain for the LMD race team. We have just six suppliers outside of Taiwan. One in the US for our engine, one in France for the tires, and then several small suppliers sprinkled throughout Europe. When you look at our supply chain in Taiwan, you notice we're heavily centered around Taipei County with a couple of suppliers in the Taichung area. As you zoom in even more, you can see we're based in Taicang, and the vast majority of our suppliers are located just 5 kilometers from our factory. Manufacturing in products in Taiwan makes it very convenient to practice local sourcing because the island is so small. With LMD and electric bikes, our initial goal was not to reduce our CO2 output, but simply to have a convenient and manageable supply chain. While we realized our initial goal, our constant trips back and forth to suppliers were much shorter and much easier than had they been based in other countries. Once we began production, the transportation of our parts and components will produce far less CO2 than if we used many offshore low-cost suppliers. As TEDs, we must design, develop, and promote environmentally friendly products and services. However, for success in the general market, beyond hardcore environmentalists, we must offer true competitive advantages for all of our environmentally friendly products. We must make environmentally friendly products that are profitable. The reason our environmentally friendly products must be profitable is that brings competition. As we encourage competition, we bring more environmentally friendly products to the market and improve the quality of those products. We must make environmentally friendly products that are fun. So many people's purchasing decisions are not necessarily driven by hardcore logic, but looks, feel, and entertainment. We must make environmentally friendly products that have amazing design. As we apply amazing design to our environmentally friendly products, the extra cost of the products can be hidden, and people love just the appearance and using the products. In short, this will lead to mainstream acceptance and normalization of environmentally friendly products. Thank you very much.